Hello, and welcome to another episode of Railroads Online. This is the Carmel Valley, but this is a different save. This is the Minimalist route, and today we're going to take a tour of the newly completed Minimalist Southwest Industries loop. This save is minimizing the number of switches that are in the setup in an effort to try an experiment to say if everybody gets better response on this. So without further ado, we are now leaving the freight depot area and heading out into the loop. We'll be traveling to the southwest corner, and we're going around the corner of that mountain. Our loop takes us first to the ironworks, then to the oil field, and then to the refinery, and then back to the freight depot. There are only 3 switches on this loop. There are some very tight turns. Some things that I want to go back and fix up, where things are not quite as circular as I'd like them to be. I jumped off a little soon. I want to make sure that this switch up here is set to the right direction so we actually go along the route that I just described. I'm glad I did, because this is flipped the wrong way. Using our Glenbrook number 60 named Kimball. And named for William Wallace Kimball, founder of the Kimball Pipe Organ Company. Now we're arriving at the ironworks. We're losing some speed here because we're coming up to one of those tight turns that I talked about. Pass through the delivery side, going around the loop to the pickup side of the ironworks. And now we're off to the oil field. We'll be coming into the delivery side of the oil field in just a moment. And then we'll have another big loop as we turn around to go back through the pickup side of the oil field. Currently sitting at about 18 switches in the entire system. So far, I've been doing a pretty solid, about 60 frames. Delivery side. As we head back towards the ironwork, track that we just came out here on, off to the left. ironworks is just over there. You can see it through the trees. As we go around behind it and into the cut, moment we'll be going up a long living bridge to get to the pickup side of the oil refinery where you pick up the barrels of oil. This is the first train that I'm running through this loop. So hopefully I haven't missed any trees in the process. Or there'll be a slight cut while I rerail the train. Out on the other side of the refinery area. Really only have two trains on this layout so far. I haven't done much with it yet. And now we're arriving at the delivery side of the refinery. First, of course, we have the oil drop-off area. And the pipe drop-off area and the lumber drop-off area. You can see I still need to do a bit of trimming around here. Now we're going to go down a long curving bridge that drops at 1.5% grade. And curves around in a 100 meter radius. I'll do another video to detail some of the other parts of the minimalist area. However, a lot of it is very similar to other railroads that I've built. It just doesn't have as much passing sightings or parking spaces as the other ones. Take off our brakes as we're nearing the bottom of this. And in just a moment, we'll be meeting up with the track that we came out on. Here's our current position as we head in north. And now we're back on the track that goes to the Great Depot. This build has one Y on it. There are a few loops. One of them is pretty big. Well, actually, this is probably just about as big as the big loop, which is a loop that goes from the 1Y out to the iron mine, down the hill to the smelter, and then back to the 1Y. You actually have to leave the Y going towards the iron mine to pass through the smelter and get up to the coal mine. And as the spawn site comes into view, we begin to reduce our speed so that we can pull up and stop at the freight depot. Woo! there you have it. The minimalist route on the Kermit Valley going to the Southwest Industries. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.